we introduce you to an original SAT vocabulary video filmed, written, directed, and edited by ninth graders in the lovely Miss Dershowitz's class at Palm Harbor High. Negligible, insignificant, very small.
Format, really? F. Jeez. Pencil? Ugh. F.
Hey, Mr. Tharin, sorry, I was
late.
Can't
even read this.
It's my commentary, man.
Isn't this late?
Yeah, but you said I could turn it in later, right?
I don't even know how to use apostrophes, man. What's wrong with you? Go sit down.
Even though the mistakes made were negligible, he still gave them a bad grade. Digress to stray from the main subject.
Hay siete u ocho palabras negativas. Nombra las palabras negativas, clase. Una palabra negativa.
Are there camels in Spain?
Camels in Spain?
Yeah.
Camellos? Sí, hay camellos en España. You know what? I really, I even took a ride on a camel.
Ah, tell us about it.
Oh, my camel was crazy.
Really?
Her name was Rosie.
Ooh.
And she would go like this. We were in a cliff, very high. And I was scared looking down because there was no rail, nothing. You just go. And then Rosie would just do this. And then suddenly, and I was screaming, and everybody, what happened? I said, the camel. Said, hey, guide, call the guide. Rosie's sick. She's going down. And then this little guy comes in. He was covered, and I couldn't see his face, but I said, this guy is really tiny. So I said, excuse me, are you the guide? And he said, yes, it's me. What do you need, lady? And I said, this camel, she's doing this, and then she does this, and she goes down, and I think she's gonna fall. And then they say, don't worry about it. She likes to have fun with the tourists. And I said, what? And then I said, that voice, is that a kid? And I said, could you please remove your hood? Because that voice. And then he removed the hood and it was a 12 years old kid. And you with Rosie going. So, but wait a minute, what are we doing? We're talking about camels? We're supposed to talk about negative words.
Everyone knows that it is easy to make Senora Munoz digress from what she is trying to teach. Denounce, to condemn openly.
Good evening, Drew. How do you feel about the theme of Great Expectations?
Well, I think that book is as stupid as you are. You can take that theme. You have Riziki. You have no idea what us McFarlanes have to go through. We have hard life. A hard life. You know anything of pain. Your tests are so easy, they're easier than... Dirty things.
When Drew's brother Dane asked him about Great Expectations, he denounced his brother and the book. Callous. Emotionally hardened or unfeeling.
The difficulties you face are nothing compared to mine. You have no struggles. None at all.
Very well. You're welcome to think what you want of me, but they have no effect on me.
But I know poison will.
Well
then. Dane was completely unaffected by the insults of his brother. He is callous. Encompass, to include, to contain.
Alright, so your homework for next time. First, I've given you a number which corresponds to your poetic term that you need to use on Moodle. You have to look up your word, write your word, the definition, find an example of it in a poem, and write your own example. Then to prepare for your vocab test next time, you need to do a vocabulary meme. Try to be more funny than Jason. Shouldn't be that hard. Also, you need to pick a poem from the Poetry 180 website to use in class next time and bring Romeo and Juliet. We'll be starting it. You might as well just read the whole thing. I might give you a pop quiz on it. Also, prepare for your vocab test next time. And since we didn't get to it today, please write a reflection. Based on all of our work with Great Expectations, you should include motif, theme, symbols, the opening and closing of the book, how you feel about Pip, and your own Great Expectations. And I might think of something else and post it on Moodle later, just to surprise you.
Mr. Tharin encompasses many tasks with many requirements in his homework load. Evoke, to call forth or provoke, produce or elicit.
Awesome, man!
You do your presidential portfolio?
Dude, I was up till like 3 a.m.
Oh, man. I can't believe
it's your
day.
Yeah, no. Presidential portfolio? Whoa. It's, what are you guys talking about? Presidential portfolio is due today.
It's due today?
Yeah, man.
I thought it was due next week.
Who told you that?
Johnny told me this.
Who's Johnny?
I don't know. What have I been doing, though? What have I been wasting my life for, then?
Andrew, calm down.
No!
Okay, man.
No, all my life I've been calm!
Hey, man, that
all my life I've just been a butterfly in a cocoon's body! I don't need this, and I don't need you!
When Andrew heard that the presidential portfolio was due today, and that he had not done it, it evoked anger in him. Lavish. Excessive. Plentiful.
Guys, get started on your color markings. Yay! That makes sense. That's good. What is this? What is this? You should be ashamed of yourself. What's wrong with you? You're wasting my time. Well, I agree. That's good. Oh my gosh, that's amazing. That is the greatest color marking I have ever seen.
Thank you.
That's impressive.
The use of so many colors made her color marking job seem lavish, yet it still impressed Mr. Tharin. Advocate, to speak in favor of.
Estoy muy preocupada and very worried because I thought that I had explained everything. Every day I spent 25 minutes explaining all these things, and then in this test, everybody got an F.
You didn't do the homework. I suspected it, but now you just confirmed my doubts.
What are you planning to do, son, to do better to improve your grades in my class?
Nothing. See, yes. Page 566. You need to do the work. If you don't do the homework, you won't get any B's or C's.
Senora Munoz always advocates that we should do our homework, but...
Ain't nobody got time for that!
Repudiate, to reject the validity of.
Cameron, the cues are due.
These were due last week.
But you said I can send them in today.
Yeah, but not like this.
Cameron, so bad you won't take them?
No, just a lot of these are copied. You tell us this in your work. And that shirt you're wearing, no way.
Coach P repudiated Brian's work because it was all copied. discreet, intentionally unobtrusive. Barnabas tried to be discreet about skipping class and trying to go see Mr. Briggs. Construe, to interpret.
So, time's up. So, what are your thoughts on Shooting the Elephant by George?
Mr. Tharin asked the class what they construed or interpreted from this passage. Specious, seemingly true, but actually logically false.
Yes, Jason.
I think that this passage is talking about Native Americans.
Whoa. What words here indicate to you that there are Native Americans involved?
Indian?
Jason, this is India as in India.
Oh, there aren't elephants in America.
No, there's nothing to indicate a zoo here. You should be very disappointed in yourself.
I'm sorry.
Jeez.
The answer that Jason gave was specious. It seemed true, but in reality, it wasn't. Scrupulous, thorough, and careful.
Nikki, how about you? Do you see anything interesting here?
Well, the arms crucified kind of makes him into a Christ figure, which kind of implies he made a huge sacrifice.
That's very astute. Good job, as always.
Nikki was scrupulous in doing her work and came up with a reasonable interpretation of the poem. Bolster, to support.
Yes! I got a 63 on the math test. That's my new high score.
Got a 75. A 75. I've never gotten a C before.
Are you serious? You're complaining about a 75.
It's
I got
C.
a 94, guys. My parents are going to kill me. I could have gotten the bonus if I tried harder. Okay, you need to calm down. That's an
you
a.
got an A.
Calm
I
down.
Got a C. A 75.
I will train you, and you will get 103. Let's go.
When Jennifer did bad on a McFarland test, Daniel bolstered Jennifer's morale and said that he would help her get an A. Espouse, to give one support.
In the crib, ma. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot. Drop it like it's hot.
Daniel espoused his wisdom to Jennifer on how to get an A. Ameliorate, to improve.
Not too shabby.
A 70? That's...
I got worse.
Oh my gosh!
I got worse. I got 103! Yes! I've improved so much! Thank you, Daniel! Thank you! You are amazing!
Daniel helped Jennifer ameliorate her grades.
A worn-out recording of a favorite song.